Hey guys, here's a quick and easy way to make a pretty good drip plate, an accurate one, or at least a fast one. First step is to make your box here, just as I've done. One's made out of acrylic. Second step, to make your holes where you want them drilled. I like to have them evenly spaced so the flow is evenly distributed, just like this. What I do is I just take a piece of egg crate, I lay it on the drip plate here, and I take a marker and I mark the areas where I want them. I generally evenly space them. I go down and then I come on, obviously not directly across from it, but I mix it up here. But it makes it pretty accurate and fast, a lot easier to get drilling. There's 140 holes here that you see, 3/16 of an inch. If you're going to be making a drip plate, it's always best to start off with a small hole, probably 1/8. I'm sorry, yeah, 1/8 or even smaller, and try your flow through it, probably in a bathtub or something. Just to see if it overflows or not, or if it can handle. In some of my other videos, I've shown that you want to have a little bit of water pooling in it, maybe 1/4 inch of water pooling in it, so that all the holes get some of the water and it's dripping, instead of all the water just dripping through the center or one side. Or you'll see that it gets lopsided if your holes are too big. Want to start with small holes and then you can increase, but if you start with big holes, you can't really go back and make them smaller because it's already done. Okay, so here's the how you're actually going to drill the drip plate. There's really no technique to it, except you just kind of want to be careful not to crack the acrylic if that's what you're using. I'm not too worried about this one because it's made out of scrap acrylic, and I have more if I break it. So, but if you don't want to break it, you want to be careful. What I like to do is have some styrofoam with some wood under it, because once you punch through, it's going to grip into the wood, and it tends to spin the acrylic or pull it down and crack it. So you can do it like this and have the acrylic or plexiglass touching whatever you're drilling on top of, and you will experience it twisting. Also, you'll need to hold it tight, and you'll smudge your marks where you've put the dots. So I like to flip it over, and that way I don't move any of the smudges. And when I punch through, I'm not really going deep into anything, and it's not going to pull the drill down further or harder and end up cracking this. A lot of this is you want to put a little bit more pressure than the weight of the drill, and it punches through very fast. You gotta be kind of careful not to crack the acrylic, but I'll show you how I get it going, and you can get pretty fast at it. Like I said, there's 140 holes here, and it's going to take maybe, I'm guessing, 20-25 minutes, something around those lines, if I continuously keep going. Maybe a little less, but here it is. So that's it. As you can see, it does punch through. That's more of my weight pushing down on it, but it does go through. You'll see that once you do drill it, there's always these little tufts of acrylic on the other side here. You want to clear those off and make sure it's a nice clean hole. If not, just put your drill through it again, and it'll take care of any tufts or anything. Now the holes obviously are more of a guideline, I miss them, but you want to stay pretty close to them. Once you're done drilling, you can wipe the marker off or or remove it somehow. I use permanent marker, so that's staying on mine. But again, I hope that helps with you making a drip plate.